Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the words of the Mesillas Yesharim, and we're describing over here the chelki haprishas, all the different, the spectrum over here of prishas, of what it means for a person to abstain and to distance themselves from the things of this world that are not necessary for them. Now he says, v'haprishas bedinim. What does it mean that a person is a parish, that they separate themselves in dinim, in the laws of the Torah? Every time that there is a machlekes, there's an argument in halacha, and one opinion is more machmir, is more stringent. If you can understand the reasoning behind the chumra, behind the stringency, even though that the Shulchan Aruch might not say that the halacha is according to that position, a parish, someone who would like to separate themselves from the everyday run-of-the-mill Torah and mitzvahs that everybody else is keeping, they would end up being concerned for the chumra, the stringency over here, and they would keep that instead. But they have to do it on condition that by keeping a stringency, it's not going to come to an overall kula, to a leniency. How does being machmer, how does being strict come to a leniency? For example, perhaps the following story will illustrate. Shlomo Zalman Arbach, who was one of the great halachic authorities of his time, was once walking in the street on Shabbos in Yerushalayim. And he sees a young man and his wife and their little kids. And he sees it's Shabbos and the wife is pushing the carriage. She's holding one baby in her arms and she got another couple of kids that are pulling on her skirt, and the husband is walking next to them as if nothing in the world. He's not helping out, he's not pushing the stroller, he's not picking up any of the kids. And if Shlomo Zalman Arbach goes over to the young man, he says, "Excuse me, why aren't you helping your wife?" And the man says, "Eruv." He says, "I don't hold of the Eruv in Yerushalayim." And Shlomo Zalman looks at the man and he says, "I used to hold of the same thing, until I saw how much effort my wife had to put in to taking care of the kids and pushing the stroller. And that's when I started caring in the Eruv of Yerushalayim. I think you should start caring also." So he was being machmir not to use the Eruv, but at the end of the day, it brought about a kula that he didn't take care of his wife in the proper way. If there's any doubt about what the halacha is, he's still going to be machmir, he's going to be more stringent on himself, even if it's possible to be mekel, to be lenient in this particular case. Ukfar be'erulana chazal, our sages have already explained to us, Maimu Yecheskel, that the prophet Ezekiel Yecheskel said the following, Hine nafshi lo mituma, my nefesh, my soul never became impure, unevelu utrefa lo yachalti, minu urai ve'arata, and from my youth until now, I never ate an animal that was not shechted, that was not richly slaughtered properly, and meat that was pigle, which means that was shechted, exactly how what he means over here, but it was shechted for the wrong reasons, in the wrong way, I never put into my mouth. Says the Gemara, I never ate meat that had a halachic question about it, whether or not it was kosher, and they went and they asked the Chacham, the wise, the Torah scholar, can you eat it or not? I mean, there's all different parameters to checking a cow after it has been checked to see is it kosher, is it not kosher. And he said, I never, ever ate a piece of meat where there was any shilas, where there was any doubts whether or not it was kosher. Even if the Chacham, even if the scholar said that it was fine, I still didn't eat it. And there's a case in the Gemara that speaks about when an animal is dying, and you say, quickly, quickly, shecht it, because if the animal dies without shechita, without slaughtering, you're not going to be able to eat it. So even though it is permissible, and a person's allowed to do that, still, Yecheskel said, I never ate that meat. Really, according to the letter of the law, you're allowed to eat these things. Vadai, certainly, ele'ihu di'achma nafshe, however, Yecheskel was stringent upon himself, and he said, I'm not going to eat anything that's even questionable. And I mentioned above, in the world of precious, you can't learn out what is permissible to everybody else, for the parish, for the man who wants to distance himself. Because Because a person who is a parish, someone that is holding by these standards of distancing themselves from other things that other people do, at any distance, the person will be careful to make sure that he doesn't do something that has even a question in halacha, even if it's mutter, even if it's possible, and the rabbi says, no problem. He doesn't want to get himself involved in such a thing. He'd rather be machmer, be stringent, and avoid the questions altogether than to rely upon a cooler, rely upon something which is leniency. But remember, the majority of all of Klal Yisrael is not going to learn like this, is not going to live like this. The majority is going to live in the world of, we do what is the letter of the law, and we don't have to do more than that. We follow in the psak, the decision of the rabbanim of our times, and we don't have to be more machmir, more strict than that. And only someone that's on that level to truly be parish, to separate themselves, should try to hold themselves to that standard. Have a wonderful day.